Please subscribe.
Go back about a decade, and Audi's audacity was on full display. Its first supercar, the R8, had just recently debuted. The R10 V12 diesel race car took the checkered flag at the 24 hours of Le Mans. The A8 W12 galvanized Audi's place among full-size luxury sedans, and in Europe, Audi introduced a hedonistic version of its Q7 SUV. Powered by a snarling, turbo-diesel 6.0-liter V12 with 500 horsepower and 738 pounds-to-foot of torque, the Q7 V12 TDI was a literal heavyweight at more than 5,700 pounds and was offered only to its European customers for the equivalent of about $985,000, making it the most expensive Audi of its day. Since then, Audi's grandiosity has receded somewhat from that high-water mark. The brand has pulled out of endurance racing. The R8 may be superer than ever, but 12-cylinder full-size luxury sedans like the A8 W12 are an endangered species. The Q7 V12 TDI's successor, the SQ7 TDI, has lost 4 cylinders and a chunk of torque, and it's half the price. And here we are in a version of the Q7 that the market hadn't considered or wanted back in 2008, powered by an engine with one-third of that mighty diesel's displacement and cylinder count, the Q7 2.0T Quattro. Faint praise for the four-pot. Since you've probably already glanced at the spec panel, you may be surprised, as were we, frankly, that with just 252 horsepower and 273 pounds-to-foot of torque from its turbocharged 2.0-liter inline 4, the Q7 2.0T accelerated from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 7.0 seconds in our testing, a not at all terrible number for a three-row luxury SUV. This could never have been possible without the extensive use of aluminum in the second-generation Q7's slightly downsized body and redesigned suspension, resulting in the loss of hundreds of pounds compared with its predecessor. Indeed, at 4,776 pounds with the full tank, this Q7 weighed approximately half a ton less than the Q7 V12 TDI and is 309 pounds lighter than our long-term Q7 3.0T. That said, the 2.0T doesn't feel that spry all the time. The 8.2-second rolling start figure shows the extent to which downshifting and turbo lag hinder acceleration, so unless one toggles the shifter into sport mode and/or places the vehicle in dynamic mode via the Audi Drive Select system, sluggishness is almost unavoidable. We found ourselves pushing the pedal to the floor often, not only due to the small engine but also because we found the throttle calibration to be lacking in responsiveness, which didn't help our fuel economy. Over the course of its stay, the 2.0T averaged 18 miles per gallon, 4 miles per gallon less than the EPA's 22 mile per gallon combined rating and just one better than we've seen in similar driving in a Q7 3.0T. However, on our 75-mile-per-hour highway fuel economy loop, the Q7 2.0T turned in a respectable 26-mile-per-gallon performance, 1 mile per gallon better than the EPA highway number and 2 miles per gallon ahead of the Q7 3.0T. At least the 8-speed automatic transmission shifts quickly and crisply, particularly in sport mode or when shifting manually with the shift lever or the steering wheel paddles. And all through the rev range, the four-cylinder spins with a sinewy smoothness commensurate with its luxurious host vehicle. Lower limits. The Q7 2.0T's comparatively lower curb weight also helps it feel nimble and responsive, changing direction quickly and predictably. But even with its optional 255/55R 19 all-season tires, a $1,000 upgrade from the standard 18-inch wheels, its lateral grip of 0.80 grams was markedly lower than the 1990s sports car like 0.90 grams of our overachieving long-termer. We should note that our long-term Q7 benefits from the optional $4,000 adaptive chassis package, adaptive dampers, air springs, and four-wheel steering, and low-profile, 21-inch summer tires, none of which are available with the 4-banger. Even so, the Bass Q7 suspension ably absorbs bumps and keeps the body from rolling excessively. The 4-cylinder's all-season rolling stock also accounts for the Q7's disappointing 186-foot stopping distance from 70 miles per hour, a whopping 31 feet longer than our heavier 3.0T despite using the same substantial 14.8-inch front and 13.8-inch rear brake discs. The Q7 2.0T's optional 20-inch wheels and 285/45 series all-season run flat tires might represent a worthwhile expenditure, especially considering that they only cost another $800 more than the 19s on this vehicle. Oh, and take note, towing enthusiasts, as this one is rated to tug a trailer up to 4,400 pounds. Gray matter. The relative humility of our test example was accentuated by its color scheme. Painted floret silver, a $575 option, this model's exterior was downright boring, and nowhere near as cool as our graphite gray long-term Q7 3.0Ts, with its titanium black optic package and aforementioned 21-inch wheels. Only close inspection reveals the styling nuances of the Q7's design, including flared rear fenders, serrated grille vanes, and skid plate-like lower bumper details. Helping somewhat were full LED headlights and taillights that are part of the $2,000 vision package, which also includes a top-view camera system and Audi's nifty 12.3-inch virtual cockpit digital instrument cluster. That virtual cockpit display, in fact, was the highlight of our test Q7's interior, which was outfitted with black leather. While we've sampled several other 2017 Q7s with more stylish color schemes, this one's blackness was downright gloomy, its dark gray oak wood inlays barely noticeable anywhere except for the center console. The memory card with our interior images became corrupted, so the photos in our gallery show a brown interior from a different Q7 2.0T. We think it looks far less dire, only after more time spent pressing its haptically perfected buttons and switches, scanning the razor-sharp resolution of both the virtual cockpit and the stand-up infotainment screen, and appreciating the sensible logic of its MMI infotainment system does one come to enjoy the refinement of the Q7's cabin. Front and rear seating areas feel open and expansive, thanks in no small part to the standard panoramic sunroof. We can't say the same for the third row, which is best left for wee ones or folded to make way for cargo. Sensible price. At least our test Q7's price didn't climb into the stratosphere from its $49,950 starting point. Even with the options already mentioned, the $4,000 premium plus package, including proximity key entry and push-button starting, My Navigation Plus with MMI Touch, smartphone integration, blind spot monitoring and rear cross-traffic alert, a power-adjustable steering column, LED interior lighting, and more, the $500 cold weather package, heated steering wheel and rear seats, and the $350 rear side airbags, our test car was comfortably under $60,000, totaling out to $58,375. This experience with the 2.0T didn't necessarily burnish our enthusiasm for the Q7, but it remains our favorite midsize luxury SUV. Neither did it diminish our anticipation for some of the more exciting Q7 variants that Audi has planned in the future, including an electric Q7 and even a possible RS Q7. However, we would advocate for upgrading to the $6,500 pricier 3.0T and, barring that, at least getting an interesting color.